Ryan and Morgan, you've known each other from the first glance of acquaintance to this point of commitment. At some point, you decided to marry. From that moment of yes to this moment of I do, indeed, you've been making promises and agreements in an informal way. All those conversations that were held riding in a car or over a meal or during long walks. All those sentences that began with when we're married and continued with I will and you will and we will. Those late night talks that included someday and somehow and maybe. And all those promises that are unspoken matters of the heart. All these common things and more, they're the real process of a wedding. The symbolic vows that you are about to make are a way of saying to one another, you know, all those things we promised and hoped and dreamed, well, I meant every word. Look at one another now and remember this moment in time. Before this moment, you've been many things to one another. Acquaintance, friend, companion, lover, dancing partner, and even teacher. For you've learned so much from each other these last few years. Now you shall say a few words that will take you across a threshold of life, and things will never quite be the same between the two of you. For after these vows, you shall say to the world, this is my husband, this is my wife. Morgan and Ryan, you fell in love by chance, but you're here today because you're making a choice. You're both choosing each other. You've chosen to be with someone who enhances you, makes you think, makes you smile, and makes every day brighter. Your response to these vows is I do. Ryan, do you take Morgan to be your wife, to keep her as your favorite person in your life, to laugh with her, go on adventures with her, adore her, support her, grow old with her, and find new reasons to love her every day?
I do.
And Morgan, do you take Ryan to be your husband, to keep him as your favorite person in your life, to laugh with him, go on adventures with him, adore him, support him, grow old with him, and find new reasons to love him every day?
I do.
May I have the vow books, please?
Ryan, if someone would have told me at the age of 12 that I was hanging out on the middle school, that I was hanging out on the middle school soccer field with my future husband, I would have without a doubt told them that they were crazy. But here we are all these years later, and I'm marrying the boy that I grew up with. For the last 9.5 years, you've brought me so much peace, comfort, and happiness. You are so patient, thoughtful, determined, hardworking, intelligent, witty, and fiercely loving. You put so much time, effort, and attention to detail into everything that you do, and our relationship is certainly no exception. You have taught me so much about what it's like to be loved and how to love. You acknowledge my strengths and you accept my faults. You keep me grounded, you keep me calm, and you keep me safe. Thank you for being the man of my dreams and making me feel so loved and cared for every single day. We have been through so much together, from high school graduations and proms, to starting and finishing college and university, to getting our first real jobs, to buying our first home, and now getting married. There's no one else that I would rather have by my side, and I can't wait to see what else life has in store for us. Life is chaotic and unpredictable, but I know that our love is constant. I've continuously chosen you for almost a decade, and I promise to continue choosing you for the many more decades to come. I promise to be loyal, faithful, and honest. I promise to respect you, support you, and encourage you. I promise to enjoy the good times, work through the hardships, and come out of every situation closer and stronger as a couple. I promise to be the best wife that I can possibly be and work hard for our family and our life together. And of course, I promise to scratch your back every night until you fall asleep and keep the bar fridge stocked with beer. Ryan, I am so deeply in love with you, and I can't wait to start this next chapter of our lives as husband and wife. You're my forever.
Morgan, standing in front of you here today is such a dream come true. Years in the making. How I ever got such an incredible girl like you to fall in love with such an average guy like me, I'll never understand. Yet here we are. Here you are looking like an angel. You're so beautiful. I'm truly the luckiest guy in this world, and I can't imagine my life without you. I know you have your own theory as to why I texted you out of the blue on your mom's birthday 9.5 years ago. Looking back, I don't understand how I even had your number in my phone. But those weren't coincidences. I believe God wanted to put us on this earth to be together. And that's the story we're going with from this day forward. You're funny, forgiving, smart, determined, and at times, quite feisty. I am so proud of the woman you are today, and I promise to always be your biggest fan as you take on the world. You are my best friend and my soulmate forever. I promise to never stop chasing after you and to always be the same guy you fell in love with. When we start a family together, I promise to be the best father I can be, because I already know you will be the best mother. You are the most...
Stop.
You are the most selfless person I know. And I hope our kids grow up to be even half the person you are. I want to grow old with you and look back on our life together with no regrets. Thanks to you, I've pretty much memorized every line of every Friends episode. And I promise I will continue to watch every episode with you whenever you want. Even if we just saw it yesterday. I promise to stay out of your way when you're cleaning and not step on the floors when they're still wet. And I promise to always drive and remain calm with every wrong direction you give me. But most of all, I vow to be loyal to you, respect you, protect you. God. And unconditionally love you through whatever life throws our way. I can't wait to start this next chapter of our life together. I love you so much, Morgan. God.
Do you
want to
take a minute?
No.
Now may I have the rings, please? Your moment. It's all yours. Thank you. Ryan, take this ring, place it on Morgan's left hand, and repeat after me. Morgan, I give you this ring.
Morgan, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love for you.
As a symbol of my love for you.
I offer you.
I offer you.
All that I have.
All that I have.
All that I am.
All that I am.
And all that I will be.
And all that I will be.
Morgan. Morgan, take this ring, place it on Ryan's left hand, and repeat after me. Ryan, I give you this ring.
Ryan, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love for you.
As a symbol of my love for you.
I offer you.
I offer you.
All that I have.
All that I have.
All that I am.
All that I am.
And all that I will be.
And all that I will be.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take a moment to sign the register. Please enjoy the music, and we'll be right back.
Girl, you stole my heart and changed it. Took all of my plans and rearranged them. Now I finally know what amazing grace is. When I look into your eyes, baby, I...
Morgan and Ryan, may you always find peace in your home. May you always be faithful to one another. May you always find ways to strengthen your bond with one another. May you appreciate each other's good qualities and always focus on the positive. But most of all, may your affection for one another never cease, but instead continue to grow, becoming a deeper, richer, and never-ending love. For the last 9.5 years, you've called each other boyfriend and girlfriend, and a year ago, you had to adjust to that strange word of fiancé. Today, your terms for each other are changing once again. This time for good. Morgan and Ryan, you've exchanged vows in our presence and sealed your vows by the holding of hands and exchange of rings. By the authority vested in me by this province, I pronounce that you are now husband and wife. You may seal your vows with a kiss.
I love you.
Let's give her bride back her bouquet. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise. Let us celebrate the newlyweds, as it's my honor to present to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Ryan and Morgan Faith.
Forever seems like a long time, but nothing seems like a long time. I'm walking on water since the day that I asked your father to let go of his daughter. So give me your blessing, sir. I'll give her all that I've got. It doesn't look like much, but it sure feels like a lot. Let her take my heart.